Hello people, my name is Ferdy and in this tutorial I will show you how you can create images for free using Nano Banana. With Nano Banana you can create images based on a prompt. You can adjust and refine images with a prompt. You can change clothes, you can add objects, you can add people. You can place them in different scenarios. And what I really like about Nano Banana is the character consistency. Throughout different images and different scenarios, the people in your images look the same. You can also blend multiple images. You can even blend 8 different images and let Nano Banana put it all together. So without further ado, let's get started. So in order to get started, we go to ferdy.com/Gemini. This is not an affiliate link, but it helps me to keep track of how many people click over here. I like statistics. So if you have a Google account, you can click here on Start with Gemini. If you don't have a Google account yet, you'll probably see this, or if you're not logged in, accept all. Click on sign in, then you can choose your Gmail account or you can create an account at Google and then you can sign in. So when you're signed in, you can click here on chat with Gemini, use Gemini. I prefer to work with a dark version, so I click over here. Theme, I change it to dark. Okay, so now I can ask anything to Gemini, but what I also can do, I can click over here, tools, and I click here on create images and you see the banana icon. So now we are using Nano Banana. So the first thing we can do in Nano Banana is create images based on a prompt. So let me show you how to do that. I say place an ice cream vendor in the Bryce Canyon. We get a few prompts for free, so we can get started for free, which I really like. It can take some time, and there it is after like 18 seconds. Here it is. So that's image creation based on a prompt. The cool thing is, we can do a lot of adjustment options. So I see hoodoo scoops. I can change that to change hoodoo scoops to Ferdy's ice cream party. Let's see what it comes up with. Okay, Ferdy's scoops, Ferdy's ice cream party. If I want to download this, I click over here. I can download it full size. And then it looks like this. What else can I do? I can change the weather. I can say make it noon and rainy. So there you go. You see clouds, you see rain, still smiling people. Why? Because it's still ice cream. Now let's take it a step further. Right now I want to show you how you can upload your own image and make adjustments to it with a prompt. So I will go to my desktop. There's this image of myself. I drag it over here. And I can say, put me in an expensive penthouse office with New York in the background. There you go. It's using the exact same image, so I can also adjust it. I say, turn the person 30 degrees, give him a different pose and make him sit at a really huge desk with a few computer screens with stock information. Yes, now it looks like this. Okay, and as we did before, I can change the weather. So I say, make it the golden hour in the background. So the sun is very low. So now it looks like this. I can also merge two images. So I can again drag this image over here, but I can also drag this leather jacket over here. Make the person in image one wear the jacket of the person in image two. Make it a full body shot. So you also see my feet and stuff. It will come up with a pants. I have no information about it, so let's see what it comes up with. What kind of clothes I will be wearing besides the jacket. Look at that. Wow. I like it. I do. So, of course, I want to try this. Make the person look way more masculine. Wow, like that. Okay, let's see. This is more like me. I think my head's a little bit too big for my body. So there's that image of mine with the jacket and stuff. The legs are added. I want to have myself in a picture with someone else, my colleague. How can I do that? I copy this image. I want to use this image, the generated image. I paste it over here. Then I go to my Finder, to my desktop. And this man, I only have an image of his face, but let's see what it comes up with when I say, put us together in one image in the city, New York, on a crowded street, or even better, on Times Square, in the middle of the crowd. Give the man in the second image a nice suit. So there it goes. Let's see what it comes up with. So there it is. Wow! I really like it. And I can also say, recreate the image when the sun just sets. There you go. So here's the image at night. Same image, same people, but now different time of the day. What else can I do with merging images? Well, I have a model over here. Then I have my logo. And I can say, make the model wear a white cap with the logo from the second image on the head. And there you go. Okay, it looks weird, so I can refine it. Make her stand in an office, in a penthouse, really big office. Make the head fit better. Far from perfect, but it's crazy how fast these models are getting better and better. You can also add a lot of separate images in one image and then ask Nano Banana to merge it all in one image. So let me grab a few random items. So now I go back to the website. So now I upload that image and I say, all these items organized on top of the desk. I hit enter. So there you go. They placed the drone on top of the computer. But what I like is, wow, it's if you take a look at the image, somehow it was able to recreate this with a different background. So I think that's really nice. I can refine it if I want to. I have the mouse on the right place. I have the controller, the iPhone over here, even though the bottom was not there. So in this way, you can also do a lot of cool things with Nano Banana. If you want to have faster loading times and you want to have more options or more credits, you can click on upgrade. So far we've been working with the free version. So I can upgrade my Google account for $16 or €20 per month after the trial ends. So this shows you a bit of what is possible with Google Banana. If you have your own prompt, which made something really cool, let me know. I know you can do a lot of things. You can make yourself fitter. You can give yourself a beard, gray hair. You can put yourself in any place in the world. You can make an image look like it's from the 80s or from the 70s. You can give yourself a certain sitcom style like Friends or a sitcom from the 90s. I keep on playing around with these and with other tools, and I will let you know when I learn something new. Have a great day. Feel free to subscribe for more coming tutorials, and I wish you the best. Bye-bye.